Hello there, welcome back to the Talking Poop Game Dev channel. I'm going to stop apologizing for falling off the face of Earth because it has repeated so many times that it would soon mean nothing. Instead, I'll put my life updates in the description below if you're interested, so we don't spend so much time talking about it in the video. Today I'm going to be sharing a small tutorial of my semi-final dialog system. This project is now on GitHub for you guys to debug and use for your own purposes. As usual, if you haven't watched my previous dialog system videos before, I recommend you go through them so that this video makes more sense. This is the dialog system I'll be using for my next game, or like the current game that I'm working on, and I'm also looking for a programmer to collaborate with for that. We'll make an announcement soon, so keep your eyes peeled for that. My previous dialog system from my advanced dialog system video was too bulky and full of bugs, and also I lost all my progress when migrating from Godot 3 to 4. Next time I'll be sure to back up properly. But for now, let's not dwell on more on those armature mistakes and move on. I understand it's not productive at all to keep getting stuck at the dialog system phase, but I felt I needed a writing interface or environment that was fun to write in. It was less about features than the writing experience, which I think affects game writing a lot. So, introducing Amber's Dialog System Light Edition, no bulky access. As you may know, the Amber style of dialog systems has two components. The first is to take the story and then turn it into a JSON file. This is separate from the game build itself, and this is what I have currently uploaded to GitHub. The second part of a dialog system is to take this JSON file and turn it into something visual, such as chat bubbles. This part of the dialog system will exist inside the game build that you have to code yourself. Let me walk you through the dialog editor. It's pretty intuitive. You can make a new node by clicking here or right-clicking anywhere on the screen. You can then link them to options like player options, player responses. When you're done, to keep things organized, create an end node and make sure all the last dialog nodes all point to the end node so that the dialog system, when you go and code your game, knows when the dialog ends. We also have feature nodes. Feature nodes can do three things. First, they can turn variables on and off. This is useful for saving or removing game variables. Second, they can emit signals. These two features can also be typed within the text boxes here as syntax. We'll talk more about that later. The third feature is to check conditionals. Basically, the next node will only play if all the conditions here are met. If they are not met, then play the other connected nodes. These are some in-text syntax that you can use. You can change the syntax by going to codeedit.tscn, inspector, under syntax highlighter, and color regions. These syntaxes don't mean anything now. You will have to code its effects in the second part of your dialog system in the game build. One word of advice, keep track of all the signals and animations and sound effects by scene. I use Notion for this. Being organized will help in debugging and generating assets. This is what the format looks like when your story is generated into JSON. Each dialog node is named numerically. This is to help with localization or translation of your game into other languages. Currently, my system doesn't sort the dialog keys in order by number. And since JSON sorts the number 15 higher than the number 2, because number 15 starts with 1, I suggest you go to a JSON editor online and sort it in ascending order yourself. If your JSON is not sorted numerically, it causes problems when you want to reopen the file in the dialog system again. If anyone can fix this in my system, that would be greatly appreciated. So let's say you want to change the theme. If you're writing dialogue for a cozy game and want to make your editor fun autumn colors instead of this basic blue, go to the Assets folder under UI and General Theme.tres to change it up. And to change up characters, go to GraphNode.tscn, unfold the characters group, and at the end of the group you'll see Option button. Go to Inspector and add or change the items, also known as your characters. Let's talk about bugs. I have procrastinated debugging this dialog system for the longest time, but I also decided it's not productive to sit on this project forever, so it's now on GitHub in all its buggy glory. Would appreciate any bug fixes. Here are some existing bugs that I know of so you can avoid crashing your project when you use the dialog system. The first one is deleting nodes consecutively. The editor flares up if you delete consecutive nodes. For the life of me, I can't figure out what's wrong, but for now it's fine if I don't create a huge excess of nodes and try to delete them all at once. Secondly, sometimes the colors mess up. That's not a big problem, and I'm not sure why this happens. If it's my code or Godot? Thirdly, sometimes when you open a saved file, the connections don't link properly. Fourth and lastly, that I know of, if a file is already open and you want to open a new file, while it's open, it crashes. So if you want to create a new file or open a new file, you would have better luck shutting down the program and restarting it again. So that's all for today's video. Hope this is helpful for you. And if you use the Dialog system for anything, please share with us in the comments or on Discord. Like, comment, and subscribe for the algorithm. I miss making videos and games and you guys. Again, I'm looking for a programmer to collaborate with for future games. I'll be announcing that soon with more information, so stay tuned. Thank you for supporting this channel, and I'm so happy to have all of you on my game development journey with me. Bye!